Welcome to the Swan Show, your weekly update on all things Swansea City. Coming up this week, we recreate Lee Trundle's favourite Swans goal, that classic volley against Carlisle United. And we mark White Ribbon Day with the Swans Club Ambassador. But first, ahead of this weekend's big game at Stoke City, we sit down with Martin Olsson.
Martin, bit of a mixed spell for you recently as far as club and country.
Yep.
If I can start off with country, that must have been quite something to reach the World Cup with Sweden.
Yeah, that's a big highlight, going to the World Cup. I was so close a few years ago, but we lost in the playoffs to Portugal, so I took that pretty hard. But now it just feels nice to be able to be involved in a World Cup.
What were those games against Italy like in the playoffs? I know you didn't play, did you? But you were there for both games, weren't you?
Yeah, of course I wanted to play, but it's the manager that decides that. But it was nerve-wracking sitting on the bench, especially the chances they had and the pressure they put on us. And to be honest, I'm not used to be on the bench, so I was more nervous than I am on the pitch. So it was nerve-wracking, but it was a big relief after the game.
What does it mean for Sweden to be at the World Cup?
No, it's a big achievement, especially when we had Ibrahimovic. Many people thought maybe we wouldn't go to the World Cup that quick.
Because he's retired.
Exactly, because he's retired and because he was such a big player for us. And we relied a lot on him. But we proved a lot of people wrong in Sweden, and that feels good that us players could do that.
And for you, it'll be a career highlight, won't it? To go to the World Cup and hopefully play at the World Cup.
Yeah, for sure. That's my aim. I want to play it. I want to start the games. I've had two Euro tournaments, so one World Cup would be very nice.
To make sure you get in the squad, you've got to play well for Swansea, I guess.
Exactly. Yeah. But I think these last few games has been a lot better. I'm getting forward more, the formation as well. It works for me going forward as well. But as a team, of course, we need to do better. We do.
Do you think that it helps you? Because the formation in the last couple of games you mentioned, a bit like the diamond from the end of last season, means a lot of work for the fullbacks, doesn't it? Getting up and down.
Yeah.
But you like that?
Yeah, I like that because then I have the space in front of me as well. Of course, I can play the other formations. They're good as well. But I think, when you play the other ones, there's more people usually, like if I have a winger, maybe he's in the way for me to get forward in that way. But I think when we play the diamond, it suits me a lot as well. And when I have Tom on the side, we link up good. So, but it's a lot of harder running, but I like running hard. So it's just good to run up and down. But I feel it more now when we play this formation, I can get forward also a lot more.
You scored a couple of goals last season.
Yeah.
We could do one or two of those now, yeah, Martin.
I'm wanting to score more goals than I did last season. So it's something I'm wanting to do. Of course, it's frustrating not winning games, but we just need to try and keep a cool head, and it's gonna turn around because I know we got the players for it.
Do you think that? I mean, how is the mood? It's difficult, isn't it, when you're fighting hard in games, but you're not coming away with the results you've perhaps deserved in some of them. How are you now going into this game at Stoke at the weekend?
No, we've got to take the positives from Bournemouth and Chelsea. I think defensively we were strong. There's some stuff we could have, Bournemouth, that goal he should have counted, but there's a lot of positives to take to the Stoke game. And there's a team that's around us, but we need to play like we have been doing recently. Okay, maybe be a bit more aggressive going forward, creating more chances, but we have the players for it. I've said that before. When you have Boney, Tammy, Jordan, who can take players on, Renato, I can see goals in there, so he's going to turn around soon.
And you've proved before you can turn it around. In the spring, there was that difficult run, very similar to the one at the moment, and then suddenly things changed, and you raced home at the end of the season, didn't you? Hoping for something similar now, I'm sure.
Yeah, of course. To be honest, we want to win most games. Even Chelsea yesterday, we knew we played all right, but it was hard to go in and get that loss. We want to try and win every game or get points for most of the game. So we're working hard in training. I know when it doesn't go for some for us, it's hard to get back in that pass straight away. But we're working hard, and it's looking a lot better now. I think even if you see the fans these last two games, they see we're working hard. And it's not like as it has been before. We're trying to put in a performance, and you could feel that from the fans as well with the vibe.
And on a personal note, Martin, coming up to a year since you arrived at Swansea, are you happy with the way things have gone? Are you enjoying your time in Wales?
I am happy. I enjoy it here. You know, I like playing for Swansea. I like the football. Yeah, of course, we've gone through a period where we haven't won games and played the best. But overall, I think, you know, it's been very good. And I feel I've been pretty consistent with my games. And, you know, I think the fans are greeting me very well when I'm around the city. So I'm liking it a lot. I'm happy to be here.
So the target for the next few months as a Swans player, a few more results, yep. And then hopefully off to Russia with Sweden.
Exactly, a few more results, finish higher up in the table, and maybe a few goals and assists as well, which I'm hopefully I can get.
And that will set you up nicely for the World Cup.
Exactly.
The Swan Show donned the boots to recreate some of Lee Trundle's finest goals for the club. This week, it's Trundle's favourite strike of all, that volley against Carlisle United.
So Lee, Millennium Stadium, Football League Trophy final. It was a big day for you, for the fans, for everyone at the club.
It was, for me, this felt like my FA Cup final. You know, where we was at the time with Swansea, we probably wasn't going to get to the FA Cup final. So to get to one like this was a massive game for me. And you know, just the build-up before it, where you go and get your cup final suit fitted, you know, everyone's looking the part, and going up to the Millennium Stadium, you know, a bit gutted that it wasn't at Wembley, because I'd always wanted to...
Being rebuilt at the time.
Yeah, I'd always wanted to play at Wembley, so obviously the finals had got moved to the Millennium Stadium, but probably worked in our favour, where a lot more fans could make it down, as it's only down the road. So, you know, to see the stadium all in black and white, and when you were coming up to the ground as well, to see all the fans there outside, you know, it felt like a big occasion, and they were the type of occasions I wanted to play in.
And you had the agony, didn't you, a couple of months after this, in the playoff final, which was a dreadful day for everyone involved at the club, but this one was a cracker.
Yeah, as you say, the playoff final, you know, to get beat on penalties as well is the worst. But you know, for this day, going there and winning the cup, and same again, it was sort of it was built between myself and I think they had Carl Hawley up front, who was scoring a lot of goals for them, and I used to like it when they done that, because it gave me that bit of like added pressure to go and show
that
I was the best. Yeah, it happened then, it happened with Freddie Eastwood when we played them at Southend, and it was something that I enjoyed, and you know, I always wanted to come out on top.
And you scored 91 goals for the Swans in
all?
Yeah,
91.
There was a few crackers along the way, but you'd say this was the best.
This goes down as my best. I think for the occasion, being a cup final, you know, where I scored it, all my family and friends were that side of the ground, and just the technique, you know, with the defender so close to me and being out wide to be able to get the volley in and to put it in the far corner. I think the technique out of all of them, that goes down as my best.
Let's have a look at it then. Great ball in by Leon Britton, I think, coming up.
Yeah, it was. I've closed the keeper down first. It's hit me back, come out to Andy Robinson, and he's got a tackle in. Played it to Brits, and then Brits has put the cross in. And same again, I don't think the keeper thought I was going to chest and hit it there. You'd probably take that down usually, but, you know, it was my chance to get my first shot of the game, and, you know, to score with your first shot was pleasing for me, and it set me on my way then to have a good game. The hand in set the second goal up as well, so it was a good day for me.
And it's not an easy technique, that, is it? When you're on the move into the box, one touch on your chest and ping it in the far corner.
Well, it is for me, Gaz, but speak for yourself, it's probably not.
Yeah, I've never had one of them. Your celebration, you looked a bit angry. What was all that about?
No, it wasn't anger, it was more it was joy. It was showed in that way.
Can you not smile when you've scored a goal like that?
Yeah, I think it was... You know, the pressure of being in a cup final as well, and to score that goal after 3 minutes and sort of settle all the rest of the team as well. And
release
knowing that,
the tension.
Yeah, because it is a lot of tension going into it. I remember even before the game, when I was in the dressing room, I felt a little bit lightheaded and everything. And, you know, it was just the occasion of the game. So probably a lot of built-up tension to score a goal like that and let it out. It sort of settled me down and then relaxed me for the rest of the game.
And there's quite a lot of pressure again now. You've told me that you're going to score that goal again in one take, so let's go.
Well, the only difference is, Gaz, it's you crossing me the ball and not Leon Britton, so It depends on what your service is like.
I'll do my bit.
Well, if you do your bit, I'll do mine.
Right. Good luck.
Thank you.
Come on, mate. So here we go then. Carlisle, first few minutes. Leon Britton's put a bit of timber on down the right flank. In comes the ball. Not even close.
That was a good ball.
What's wrong with that?
We're trying to recreate a Carlisle goal, not make a new one up. So the penalty spot.
That was right on the money.
Watch it. Like that.
Yeah, all right, he scored 100 Football League goals. Floats one.
I'm not going to be able to chest that in there.
You were on the run. That's on the money. Finish. Yes, Trund. Wrong post.
Wrong post.
Nice
wrong
finish pass. Though. That's the one.
Oh, that was a great ball.
Good balls.
Go then, this is the one. Britton floats it in. Chest, volley.
The Swans delivered a much improved performance against Bournemouth last weekend when they were denied victory after Wilfred Boney's strike was controversially ruled out by the referee. There was plenty of defensive grit on show at Chelsea in midweek, but a shortage of attacking threat from the Swans meant Antonio Rudiger's goal was enough to earn victory for the home side.
Every year we hold a White Ribbon event, so White Ribbon Day is actually the United Nations Elimination of Male Violence Against Women Day. So this means that globally, so everywhere around the world during this time, they're holding very similar events. So in Swansea, again, it is about raising the awareness of domestic abuse and wider violence against women issues out in the community. So we have professional people attending, those who live in our communities, those that attend the centre already. And also it is about showcasing what support we have in Swansea. Because Swansea, we have loads and loads of information, loads of support services to help those that are victims of domestic abuse and any other violence issue.
Yeah, I think it's very important. You know, I've been to this one a few years on the run now, and it's a nice day to get everyone together, but most of all to raise awareness. You know, there's a lot of things going on in people's lives where they might not want to speak out about, and you know, if you can raise awareness on it and get people to come and speak to, you know, to the people that work here, it's brilliant.
Is really crucial that we get the message out into the community. So it's not just about raising awareness with professionals, as most people assume, but it is about making sure that those in the communities that are affected by domestic abuse and wider abuse issues obviously know what those issues are, how to get support and where to go to.
Swansea as a city, you know, we are a community. The football club is a massive part of that, and the football club's a good vehicle to get coverage out there for things. So whether it's something like this, you know, even if it's other sports, the football club help out in everything. And, you know, that's what we're about. We've always been a club that has got into the community and tried to help people. And, you know, that's something that we'll continue to do.
White Ribbon Day for us is all about getting men and boys involved in ending violence against women. So having a role model, especially like Lee Trundle, and today you could see how important it was for the young boys that were here to actually just see him discuss all the work that they do with him. It just means that they've got a really positive role model and a male role model, which is really important, that can also stand up in the community and say Swansea City Football Club and Lee Trundle himself, you know, doesn't agree with any form of violence against women. And that message does really filter down to those young boys.